Victoria here of Aboki Meats. So on this channel, I do tutorials on machine knitting using a KH811. In this video, I want to show you how I made these shorts, which fit a three-year-old. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe. Stay tuned and see how I did the shorts. Thank you.
So I'll take a measurement of 43. Starting with the left side, so I'm starting with one leg and then the other leg, the right. First do the right and then after you do the left. So I'll cast on the waist yarn to begin with. And then I'm using tension 5 for this shirt. Knit one row. Then pull all the needles back into the working position. And knit a few rows. Increase the tension to 7. So after you pass a nylon cord, if you have one, mine is kind of misplaced, so I'm going to use a different color and pass one row. Just knit one row. Then back, I'll put the row counter back to 000 and work on the hem. Knit 20 rows. Then making a picot, I want to choose this other main color, other color. Just knit one row, then you transfer one to the next following. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, you can go on ahead, please, and subscribe. Give the channel, make sure you hit the notification bell so that you get notified when I upload new videos. And you leave a comment for me down below. Let me know what you want me to do next. Then after this, I'll bring back all the needles into the working position. Alright. One row. Then switch back to white. And continue 20 rows. Fold the hem by picking this white back to the working bead. Start from this side. Now I'm going to switch to this new one. At this point, if you want, you can remove the waste yarn by pulling out this either nylon cord or the different color of yarn that you have used. So now taking back the tension to the row counter back to 0, 0. I'm maintaining tension 7. I'm going to knit 20 rows. So at row counter 30, using the transfer tool, I'll cast off 5 needles this side after 2 rows and 10 needles this side after 2 rows. Alternatively, as I cast off this, as I reduce this side, the same side I'm going to do this side. Remember, this is our front and this is our back. This is the second time, this is the third time. At this point, I'm not decreasing here, but I'll continue decreasing here, 5 more needles. making it 10 this side and 5 here. So I'm going to continue knitting up about 4 T-rows for the upper end. So I'm going to switch back to white for the waist. I'll knit a few rows here, reduce the tension to 5, and I'll knit a few rows about 15 rows. Increase the tension to 10, knit one row, then back to tension 5, remove that one row and knit more 15 rows. So now you pick this white and you put it back to the machine. So one side of the leg is done. This is the left side. I'm going to go ahead and do the right side. And then after we can join them. You can stretch this. With the two pieces ready, I'm going to join first this part up to where the crouch is, where we cast off, where we did the decrease. I'm joining first this part and then also the second one. I'm starting with the white since it's what we did the hem with. I'm using this yarn needle, of course, with a blind stitch method. If you haven't seen how I've done the blind stitch method, you can go ahead and check out my previous videos of how I did, of how I made the scarf. I did it with the mittens. You'll be able to learn something. To remove this needle, can see I'm done with this first leg. Then I'm going to go ahead and also join this other leg. Then I'll come back and I show you how to join the upper part. So now I've finished joining this other leg. Now I'll have to join these two together. Just like this, still with a blind stitch method. Pick up a stitch from one end, so you come to this end, pick up a stitch, and you go all the way up, and then after I also do the same thing at the back. So at this point, I want to add in the code, the I code that is going to be like a string for the waist. I have a video of how I made this I code. If you haven't watched it, you can go ahead and see how it's made. So I'm using this large hook. Then also this part. And now you have to tell the difference between the front and the back. Remember, the back had a longer crouch as well as the front. Different from the front, since at the back we had cast off 10 rows and the front we had cast on 5. We had reduced by 5 at the front and we had reduced by 10 at the back. So be sure to identify that. And from my view, this is the front. Realize this is the back. So, so now I can go on ahead and I join these two with a blind stitch here as well as this part. All right. So the pants are ready, the shirt, sorry. This can fit a 1-year-old, a 2-year-old, a 3-year-old. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe. Give this video a thumbs up. Leave a comment for me below in the comment section and let me know what you think about the video. Thank you so much for watching.